just love and grace for everyone, for everyone. Thank you.
The theme for this evening is leaning into the everlasting arms of our loving God. So I'd like to gather us with these words from St. Patrick's Prayer. We're going back to St. Patrick's Day. Christ with me, Christ before me, Christ behind me, Christ in me, Christ beneath me, Christ above me, Christ on my right and Christ on my left, Christ when I lie down and Christ when I sit down, Christ in the heart of everyone who thinks of me, Christ in the mouth of everyone who speaks to me, Christ in the eyes that see me, and Christ in the ears that hear me.
Yeah.
The scripture passage for this evening is the same scripture passage we used in worship this morning. It's the passage that Pastor Deborah preached from, Psalm 139. Listen to these beautiful words. O Lord, you have searched me and known me. You know when I sit down and when I rise up. You discern my thoughts from far away. You search out my path and my lying down and are acquainted with all my ways. Even before a word is on my tongue, you know it completely, O Lord. You hem me in behind and before, and you lay your hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is so high I cannot attain it. Where can I flee from your spirit? Or where can I go from your presence? If I ascend to heaven, you are there. If I make my bed in Sheol, you are there. If I take the wings of the morning and I settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me and your right hand shall hold me fast. So search me, O God, and know my heart. Test me and know my thoughts. And if you see any anxious way in me, lead me in the way of everlasting. I have such a tender memory of this psalm. For you see, each fall at Princeton Theological Seminary, we would welcome between 25 and 30 international students to the seminary campus. And they would come to study for the year. And we'd invite them to come to an early orientation so they can get over jet lag and get settled in, get a bank account, set up their computers, and everything they needed. Students came from South Korea, Nigeria, Brazil, Germany, Scotland. We had a student 1 year from Iceland, Malaysia, Ghana, Costa Rica, India, South Africa, France. It was really global. But the first thing we would do when they got there is we would invite them to our chapel where we had set up a circle of chairs, and we would read this psalm. And when we read that verse that says, where can I go from your spirit? Or where can I flee from your presence? If I take the wings of the morning and settle at the farthest limits of the sea, even there your hand shall lead me and your right hand shall hold me fast. That spoke to their hearts in this new country, this new place. And it still speaks to our hearts today, because maybe we haven't traveled across the seas, though some of you have, but we all feel a little disconnected in the world today. And I think there's so much going on, there's so much information to process, so much news to process, that it's just so reassuring to know that God is with us, that God hems us in behind and before, above and below, and that God loves us that much. Back in my 20s, there was a preacher named Tony Campolo. Anybody remember Tony Campolo? Yeah, thank you, Ted. He was a fabulous preacher known for his wit and humor, and he used to preach a lot about how much God loved us, also invited us to lives of service. But when he used to talk about how much God loved us, he always would use this expression. He said that God loves you so much, if you opened God's wallet, there would be a picture there of you. One of the pastors that served in the church before me in New York City said he was always inviting the congregation into this expression. He'd always say, lean back into God's everlasting arms. So whether it's a wallet with your photo or leaning back into God's everlasting arms, we just want you to know that God sees you and loves you and is with you always. So as we prepare for communion, I'd like to invite you to do something a little different tonight. We'll give it a go. We'll see how it works. There are sticky notes on the table. Would you just take a minute or two on a sticky note or two or three, just to write down those names for God that are close to your heart, be it Father, Mother, Redeemer, Creator, whatever it is, or the characteristics of God that you need to see right now, forgiving, loving, holding, whatever it is, names for God, characteristics for God. In a few moments when we come to the table, we're going to invite you to bring those notes and post them around the border of the mirror. So take a few moments to prepare your hearts, and then we'll gather at the table.